Greetings from Sri Vidyaniketan Public School, Sridharanagar. Today's our topic is land resources. We know that the earth is covered with on the earth we see that 2/3 of the part is being covered with water and 1/3 is covered by land. This clearly indicates that land is limited. One third of the part is being covered with land. This land is very, very essential on which we live and we carry on so many economic and non-economic activities. Say for example, cultivation, construction of industries, construction of building, houses, whatever is there. For everything we make use of land. Since it is limited in what you call size, it cannot be increased. The water in the ocean, the water bodies can increase. When the glaciers get melted, what happens? The volume of water may increase, but there is no possibility of increasing land. So it is a limited resource and hence it is called as finite magnitude. On this finite magnitude or limited land, whatever is available, it is further again what you can categorize by certain relief features. For example, plains, mountains and plateaus, etc. Here we see in India, the available land what we have. India has got what you call 3.28 million square kilometer of land area. Out of it, 93% of the statistical data is available to us. Whatever is available to us, from that 43% is being covered with plains. Here these are very fertile lands and this is useful for cultivation sake. And the next one is what you call mountains, which covers 30%. Here in the mountains we see that 30% of the land is being covered. Mountains are helpful for us and from there we see that so many rivers rise. And in the same way, the next one is plateaus. Here 27% of the area is being covered with plateaus. We know that these are the rocky areas which contains rocky mountains and there large number of what you call minerals are available. Then we see in India how the land is being utilized or land utilization we call. Further we see that here point number one is forest. We see that is anyone is going to grow the forest? No, nobody of us are going to grow any kind of forest. By nature or naturally some trees grow and they form the forest. Hence we see that certain area which is being occupied by forest where which cannot be used by us or we are not making use of it. Second point, we see that land not available for cultivation. Land is there but it is not useful for cultivation. Barren and waste land it is called. It is a dry land which is where water facility is not there, hence we are not in a position to make use of that land. In that another one type is there, that is land put to non-agricultural uses such as construction of buildings, construction of a canal, construction of roads, construction of buildings, construction of railway tracks. Likewise, for human habitation and for other constructions as such, land is being made use. Over that, we cannot make use of any kind of cultivation. And the third type is other uncultivated land. Here also we have subpoints like permanent pasture and grazing lands. These are the, since we have, how we have population in our country, the same way, we do have what you call livestock also. To feed these livestock, we need to grow what you call pastures. So here we see that there are certain glands over which to feed these animals we are growing, or what you call, they are called as the grazing glands. The next one is land under miscellaneous trees. Trees or crops we call. So what are the miscellaneous trees? There are certain trees which are not useful to us, hence it is being grown over there. So such kind of land where nobody has grown the trees, they are not useful to us also, but that land is not being utilized for cultivation sake. And the third one is culturable waste land. Here land is available, but it is not being, what you call, utilized for cultivation past 5 years. So this land, this comes under the third category, that is other uncultivated land. The next one is fallow land. Under fallow land, you see the current fallow land is which is left uncultivated from less than 1 year as such. Maybe due to lack of finance, equipment are not cultivated, or else due to lack of what you call monsoon rains, people have left the land fallow. In the same way, second category in this is other than current fallow land, which is left uncultivated from 1 to 5 years. Take for example, maybe there are what you call a monsoon rains, they did not get, as a result the land is not being put to use, or they may be having some financial problems. The next one is net sown area. What is net sown area? For example, if 2 acres of land is available, and this in 2 acres of land, minimum what you call one crop has been cultivated, is called as what you call a net sown area. Another one word is used, that is called as, it is nothing but gross crop area. In the sense, sometimes we see that in a particular land, we may make use of either the second crop or third crop. For example, 3 crops if we are taking in that, if this land area has been multiplied by the crop, 2 acres remains the same, and over this 2 acres, how many crops we have cultivated? 3 crops we have cultivated, means 2 threes are, it is going to be 6. So this is how we see that this is called as gross cropped area. Land use pattern in India. We know that India has got what you call 3.28 million square kilometer of area, and in which we see we have 93% of the statistical data is available. Where is the rest of the 7? So this 7% area, statistical data is not available to us. Why it is not available? Here we see in Jammu and Kashmir, we have POA area, that is Pakistan occupied areas there. Apart from that, in Assam, there also, in the northeast state like Assam also, certain areas we do not have an account, and in the same way, some area has been occupied by what we call China. As a result, we see that we have the statistical data of 93%. Out of this 93% area, what we have, land area, according to 1960-61 and 2008 and 9 report, the land use pattern report which is available to us, we see here forest, 1960-61, 18% of what we call forest were there, whereas in 2008 and 9 we see that there is an increase in the forest area. Similarly, you see here, that is barren waste land, which was 12.1% in 1960-61. Here we see it is being reduced to 8.61, means here the land is being bought under cultivation, that is in net sown area, what we call. At least we are able to take one crop in a year. This clearly indicates that maybe people may have, we have used certain scientific methods, fertilizers, pesticides, and what you call, by increasing the fertility of the land so as to meet the needs of the people, this area is brought under what you call a cultivation in the net sown areas. So in the same way, non-agricultural land, 4.45% in 1960-61, whereas it is being increased to 5.5%. Here we see that in the same way, now we go for net sown area, which is very, very important. Actually, we are supposed to see the net sown area, what was in 1960-61 and what it is in 2008 and 2009. So in 1960-61, the net sown area was 45.26%, whereas an increase is being found in 2008 and 2009. That is, the net sown area has been increased to 46.24%. This chart you will get in page number 6 of the geography textbook. If you refer it, you will get still clarity on that. Now we see the next unit, that is land degradation and the conservation. So with regard to land degradation and conservation, we see what are the causes of land degradation. We see first, there are various causes for land degradation. Here we see the first type is deforestation. Apart from that, overgrazing, mining and over irrigation. These are the factors which are responsible for what you call a land degradation in India. Then we see that which are the places. Take for example, in Punjab and over irrigation. In Punjab and Haryana states, large amount of land has been degraded due to what you call over irrigation. This is the main cause. Similarly, Orissa and Jharkhand region, mining activities has caused land degradation. Then in Gujarat and Maharashtra, overgrazing is the main cause responsible for what you call a land degradation in Gujarat and Maharashtra. Similarly, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, in this region we see that deforestation and even mining activities are main causes for land degradation. Then it's our duty that land is a finite magnitude. We already said it cannot be increased, whereas we see land is being degraded here. And what is the solution for that? The solution for that is conservation. We need to conserve land resources. It is very easy for you that by referring these points, just opposite of that, if you go there, you can conserve land resources. The very first one problem we are seeing, that is deforestation. To overcome this deforestation, what we have to do? We need to go for afforestation, that is planting of trees. We need to grow the forest, because land is being degraded. To prevent this degradation, we are supposed to go for afforestation. Second one is overgrazing. Due to overgrazing also, land is being degraded. So as to protect and conserve or preserve the land resources, what we have to do? Check overgrazing. What do you mean by check overgrazing? Here it is said that we should not make the cattle or the animals to graze the complete land. Means there we need to put a check or control that some part should be grazed and some should be left it. This overgrazing should not cause any kind of what we call a land degradation. The next one is mining. Can we say that mining can, because of mining we are extracting so many minerals. Can we stop mining activities? No, we cannot stop mining activities. Only thing we can do that, we can have control over the mining activities. And the next one is over irrigation. In over irrigation, we see that, again we see that, can we stop over irrigation? Sometimes we see that, here we see that control over irrigation. How can we control over irrigation? We can control over irrigation problem by making use of either the sprinklers or the drip irrigation facilities. If we adopt this overflow of water, what is causing land degradation, that can be prevented. Hope you might have understood today's topic, that is land resource, and based on that, worksheets will be provided to you and you need to complete the worksheets. Thank you.